Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim set to arrive in the Philippines today. He will later hold a bilateral meeting with President Marcos Jr. to discuss areas of mutual concern such as security and economic cooperation. The two leaders are also expected to talk about issues hounding the Asia-Pacific region. Anwar will be in the Philippines until March 2nd, during which he will also deliver a lecture at the University of the Philippines and meet with the Malaysian community. Anwar is the first head of government to visit the country under the Marcos administration. This is also his first official visit to the Philippines since becoming prime minister last November. The House proposal calling for a constitutional convention to amend the Philippines' 1987 charter moves a step closer to final approval. The chamber on Tuesday passed on second reading the resolution of both houses, number 6, through voice vote. But Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel points out only 40 of the more than 300 lawmakers took part in the crucial vote. He hopes more lawmakers can join the deliberations.
Now that second reading has been done, I think for the purposes of transparency, mainam din na malaman ng mamamayang Pilipino na ngayon pinag-uusapan natin yung ating konstitusyon. Subalit sa ngayon, no, of course, with all due respect sa lahat ng mga kapwa natin na mambabatas, ngayon po physically present sa ating second reading, we conducted our voice vote with only around 40 out of the 300 plus members of the House. And we hope that in the upcoming deliberations, we have more members who can participate and join our voting.
Prior to the vote, House Committee on Constitutional Amendments Senior Vice Chairman Lorenz Defensor got the plenary to amend the resolution. Under the amended resolution, CONCON delegates will try to limit charter change discussions to the economic provisions of the 1987 Constitution. President Marcos earlier said is not keen on the idea of amending the charter.
Philippine senators, meanwhile, expressed concerns over the proposal to create a constitutional convention. For Senator Robin Padilla, who's chair of the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments, the cost of CONCON alone is a deal-breaker. Under the House proposal, CONCON delegates will each receive 10,000 pesos per day on top of their travel and lodging allowance.
Una, papayad ba ang taong bayan dyan? Napakamahal niyan. Sobrang mahal niyan. Naglabas yung NEDA. Eleksyon pa lang, 28 billion na. Wala pa yung gastos ng pasweldo sa mga CONCON delegates, opisina nila.
Padilla also asserts only economic provisions should be entertained and wants it done through a constituent assembly. Senator Sonny Angara likewise points out, convening a CONCON is the most expensive and tedious way in changing the charter. Senator Riza Ontiveros, for her part, says, we should do away with what she calls long-standing tale of make-believe that charter change will solve all the country's problems. Senate Minority Leader Popo Pimentel also insists charter change should be the least of government's priority. He argues that people are too preoccupied with daily living struggles. The Philippine Coast Guard detects an oil spill from a vessel that capsized in the waters near the southwestern province of Orientan, Mindoro. The Princess Empress sank in the early hours of Tuesday, with 800,000 liters of industrial oil in its cargo hold. The vessel was sailing from Bataan to Iloilo when it encountered strong waves, leaving it half submerged. The ship's 20 crew members were rescued by a passing cargo vessel. The Coast Guard says the oil spill is 5 kilometers long and 500 meters wide. A team has been dispatched to contain the oil spill. The Environment Department says it's monitoring the site for potential marine biodiversity impacts and the possible risks to lives and livelihoods in the area. Energy Secretary Rafael Lotilia also calls on local oil companies to help the Coast Guard in containing the oil spill.
Philippine President Marcos Jr. affirms his administration's support for Filipino seafarers. He spoke Tuesday at the Philippine Maritime Industry Summit in Manila, where he vowed to prioritize improvements for the sector. The president called for the creation of a development plan to expand the country's merchant fleet and improve the training of maritime personnel. His remarks come as thousands of Filipino seafarers face the risk of losing their jobs after the European Union threatened to ban them from its vessels over training deficiencies. Philippine Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says the government is taking steps to comply with the EU's requirements.
ang ginawa ng bagong administrasyon ay sinasabi namin sa kanila ano na yung ginawa namin, no? What we have implemented as part of what the previous government has submitted to the EU, no? Palagay ko naman ay wala namang mawawalan ng trabaho doon sa ating mga seafarers, no, na naka-assign sa Europe.
Filipino fisher folk hold a protest against reclamation activities at the Manila Bay. They say the projects threaten the livelihood of over 100,000 fishermen. Details in this report.
Fisher folk from Metro Manila and Cavite on board dozens of boats went out to the Manila Bay to protest reclamation activities there. The fisher folk claim land reclamation will mean a smaller fishing area for them. The fishermen lament this is their only source of livelihood.
Pag tinambakan nila dito yung ano, yung Manila Bay, hanggang dun sa may Cavite, ang lahat ng mga tao nga namin dun, pati isdaan, eh hindi na namin mapakinabangan yun. Mawawalan na kami ng ano, ng hanap buhay.
One fisher folk group suspects the reclamation projects would also drive them away from their homes located in coastal areas. They warn about 100,000 fishermen in Metro Manila and nearby areas will be affected by the projects.
Ang isda na dapat nahuhuli dyan ay hindi na mangyayaring makahuli ka dahil magiging lupa na ang lugar. Pagka nag-develop itong mga reclamation na to, tatanggalin ang kanilang paninirahan sa tabing dagat. Kasi lagi namang kaming itinuturing na basura sa tabing dagat.
Fisher folk in Zambales, Bataan, and Quezon Province also held protests against planned reclamation projects there. There are at least 13 reclamation projects at the Manila Bay. 10 are ongoing, while 3 more are already approved but still do not have a contract. The reclamations will lead to the creation of about 3,500 hectares of land area. The Philippine Reclamation Authority asserts they conducted public consultations that included fisher folk before they approved the reclamation projects.
Sa pag-approve po namin ng project, na-consider naman po lahat yung mga effect na yan, especially sa community, sa mga fisher folks na ano, na magpa-apektuhan nung dredging and the reclamation. Aware naman po kami dyan.
The agency asserts reclamation is necessary because coastal cities and towns are already congested.
Talaga ho, ang reason nila is urban sprawl. Sobrang daming tao, and dense, very dense na ho yung kanilang lugar, and wala na ho silang space for economic activities.
The Philippine government vows to help fisher folk who will be affected by giving them equipment so they can fish farther out to sea, while others will be given jobs by companies who will benefit from the reclamation. ABS-CBN News tried to get a reaction from the Philippine Environment Department, but it has yet to issue a statement.